Hello. How are you feeling? I was told I could find you up here. Don't be afraid. I'm here now, and we'll work this through together. Yes. You know me, don't you? Do you not recognize these? I've been in your position before. I've been in your position 3 times. Don't you remember? I'm the champion from District 4. 3 times winner because I chose to go back in. Come on. Don't be afraid. You've got the best teacher. And we're going to go through multiple things today in your lovely penthouse suite to prepare you for the game. Well, my name is Lauren. Nice to meet you. Looks like we've got a lot of work to do. Yes, these little symbols here symbolize every person I had to get. First, we need to calm you down because you're very, very stressed out, I see. Where's your spirit? Where's the fight? You did, after all, volunteer. I see. You volunteered, but are having last minute nerves. Come on. We've been taught to do this all our lives. Make District 4 proud. Here, just tense and let's just relieve some of the stress. Little shoulder massage for you here, down your neck. That's it. Just roll your head. Get rid of all that tension. That's it. Fighting spirit. Perfect. What do you want to start with? Your appearance? Skills? Or weapons? Weapons. Okay, well, I brought a selection with me. Of course, you understand. The first thing you need to do when you are at the games is you need to run to the central point. Everyone will head there first. Some districts are taught to just run, but you want to get there first and you need to fight your way out because no weapons, no game. And there will be people that pack together and will try and own the weapons bit. So, okay. This is the first weapon. This is a hammer. It's nothing special. A hammer that nobody goes for ever. Nobody will fight you for this. But you know how to swing. This way, that way, that way. It'll come in handy, trust me. Especially if you're good at climbing trees. Okay. The next one I'd like you to go for is this, the bullet pen. Can you hear the bullet? This is an excellent device because it shoots. It's very small, very light, easy to carry, and it will shoot away. And there's different types of bullets for different types of things. There's ones with anecdotes in them. There's ones that'll paralyze your enemies. Lots of things. As for if you, for example, get stung by a jibber jabber. So I would recommend you go for this. It's small enough, and usually people miss it. But I've managed to find it. Beside the bone arrows, but be careful because District 12 like to go for the bone arrows. We have this here. This is the reflective tape. It has invisible properties and is great if you want to camouflage. So you basically do it like you normally would any other day. You put this around the area you'd like to, and it will help you camouflage. You can even use it for different booby traps. That's what I would say is a good . These here are cufflinks that are great to get hold of, because if you were down and wrestling someone on the floor, you can unleash these, which will unleash and shoot the person that is trying to kill you. So I would recommend these as a last resort. Again, it's another method of firing. It has more of an accurate range, so there's only three types of bullets. You've got red, yellow, and white. And you can see through in that section. And what it allows you to do is to target your opponent from a far away distance. You only have three, so you want to use it for the people who are the hardest to get, which is where climbing trees will come in handy. And you've got three types, and you need to decide which type would be best. So one is a bomb, another is an arrow, and the third is just a simple platinum bullet. But you need to choose wisely. I think we ought to move on a little bit and just do how about we break this up, and perhaps we could do a few of your vital sign assessments just now that we've got the weapons out of the way, because that's the most stressful bit. Oh yes, there's loads of other weapons, very basic ones like your swords, etc. But they're the ones that I would like you to go for, because everybody else will go for the axes and the swords and the obvious instruments, when and as you need to be sly. Now, let's just do a quick examination. I know you've been to see the doctor several times, but I've got to take down on my ticky sheet some gentle eye examinations. Just follow the pen for me. Follow my finger. Okay, and up. And all right. Okay, I'm just going to take some blood as well. Warm, would you like me to take? Let me just measure your height. Yes, it's for your design. I have some items to show you, but we need to get your clothes officially tailored, so. You're 5'11". Pretty tall. Pretty tall indeed. I'm very tall. I'm 5'10". That's why we are almost on par. Okay, can you please, I need to do your shoulder span. Yes, just do this for me. So I'm ready. Been officially tailored, but I needed to do a few little double checks. Well, the designer just asked me to, so I thought I would. Okay, would you like to do some camouflage? Yes, excellent. Okay, now hold out. Here you are. Okay, I'm going to show you what to do. So camouflage is a skill that not many people have, but it's very important and goes well with those weapons that I have shown you. So, first of all, this will erase and give you a basic foundation for building your camouflage on top of. Okay, hold still. See you soon. Okay. Then we're going to put this on top. That's it. So this is for the brain. So you want to do it like this, then use this hand to do your shading. That's it. Like so. Okay. Then you want to do your base color. The leaves are green. You want to do use this palette and use the end green for your leaves. They give you the best shimmery green leaf effect, and they take on the colour of the surrounding bushes. you understand that there's loads of different greens and colours of brown, etc. in the environment, and these green colours will take on all the kind of green shades to let you blend in. Okay, so hold your hand out. Going to need this here to bring it to life, and this pot. Okay, then this is see how I did that. If I bring out a stem, if I do that, okay. We also have look at your hand. See? Yes. Did you pay attention? No. Do you think you could do that in the games? Okay. Okay. Is that making you feel a little bit? Also, these are very important because each represents an item. Overnight tent, you basically unlock and twist the blue cap, and a tent will appear or be flown down to you by parachute if it's not already there. You then have orange for fire, but you want to be careful because you don't want to be seen. What's good is that there's different settings, so you can make your fire as small or as large as you'd like. If you see the also this, which is lemongrass. No, it's not just normal lemongrass. It is healing lemongrass. So what happens is, if you have a cut or an injury, it won't fix any major tissue damage, but minor tissue damage. You take this, you put a couple of drops, drop, and it should close your wound and stop infection. So this is a very good one to get hold of. Again, sometimes these are dotted around the park, so it just completely depends what you find. Not everything is in the central point. symbol